Good morning all. In this session, we are going to see the next two topics, that is generic requirements for test tool or the framework. So here we can have 19 requirements are there for test tool or the framework. We'll see one by one. First requirement is no hard coding in the test suite. That is, we need to keep all the variables separately in a file. That means what is called as a variable? A variable for a test suite is called as the configuration variables, and variables and corresponding values are stored in a configuration file. So this file should be kept separately. That is, variables belonging to a test tool and the test suite need to be separated so that whoever user uses the test suite should not worry about the test tool variables. So diagram which has been shown to the right side of the generic requirements is test framework configuration parameters. Here they have given the path for the test tool and also the common library functions and the test suite path. That is, we can have the sum of the path variables. We should not modify the path variables unless or otherwise we are consulting our system administrator. Next requirement is test case or suite expandability. That is, we need to add some of the extra test cases which should not affect the other test cases. And we can also add a new test suite. That is, test suite is the combination of test cases and the scenarios to the framework, should not affect existing test suite. And also, whenever we are adding the new test case, should not result in a retesting of the whole test suite. Next requirement is reuse of code for different types of testing and the test cases. That is, whenever we consider the login example, that is login operation, what happens here? We need to consider a different scenarios to do a different types of testing. So we can cover the number of test cases as well. So here what happens, we can reuse the code. So in this case, test suite should do only what the test is supposed to do, and this test framework will take care of how we need to do the test cases. For this, test programs, whichever contains the test cases, it can reuse their code, and also it needs to become a modular programming. Next requirement is automatic setup and cleanup. That is, each of the test program should have a setup program, because not all the test cases will be run as usual. It can have some of the prerequisites to run the objects to be configured or the programs to be configured before executing the test cases. So in such cases, manual intervention must happen, because it is not possible to remember all the setup before running the test cases. So we need to have this program to have a setup program that will create a necessary setup before executing the test cases. So this setup is called as the automatic setup, and also it is very important to clean up the setup, that is undo the setup soon after the test cases has been executed fine. That is the cleanup program. Next requirement is independent test case. That is, to execute a particular test case, you should not depend on any of the test cases which has been executed previously or any of the test cases which has to be come after this. So in this case, whenever considering the two test cases, that is test case 2 to be executed after test case 1, you should not be dependent on the all the test cases. Next requirement is test case dependency. Here what we need to see is, we need to take care of the particular test case to be executed before or the previous one, that is a dependent test case should be there. So this is a contradiction to the previous independent test cases. This framework or the test tool should be provide this option of test case dependency. Next one is insulating test cases during execution. That is, whenever the interruption or the some of the signal happens during the test case execution, what we need to do, whenever we consider the example of automatic pop-up screen in the web browser, when while we are using the web application, what happens? It is stopping some of the events happening in the test case execution. So here, framework for the test tool needs to provide the option to block some of the events happening in the behind. Next requirement is the coding standards and the directory structure. That is, it can help new engineers whoever joins in the organization. They can see this document, that is a document consists of the coding standards and the directory structure, then he or she can understand the test suite faster and also they can maintain the test suite. Next requirement is selective execution of test cases. That is, test tool or the framework should have the facility of executing the test cases based on the selection manner. For example, when you consider the test program name 2, 4, 1, 7-10, that is the test program name is the name of the test program, and 2, 4, 1 is the test case numbers. That is, test case 2 is executed, then test case 4 is executed, then test case 1 is executed, then hyphen is being given is to choose the range. That is, test case 7 to the 10, it will be executed in the sequential manner. Next is random execution of test cases. We can also have the test cases to be executed in a random manner. So, for example, in the first example, random test program name 2, 1, 5, that is, test engineer wants the test tool or the framework to select one of the test cases 2, 1 and 5 from the test program and to be executed. In the second example, random, we can have three programs, that is test program 1, test program 2 and test program 5 can be chosen random wise. And also in test program, if it is chosen, we need to choose the test cases among 2 and 1 and 5. Next one is parallel execution of test cases. It is similar to the operating system, whichever has the multi-processing and the multitasking. So here also we can have the test cases to be run in parallel, and also we can have number of that is instances to be happening. Here for the example, in the first example, instances come up 5, test program 1 of 3. Here 5 instances of the test program 1 will be created with the test case 3. Then in the second example, instances come up 5, test program 1, test program 2, test program 3, and in test program 1 of 2, 1, 5 is 5 instances of 3 test programs are created with the test program 1 with the test cases, corresponding test cases 2 and 1 and 5. Next requirement is looping the test cases. Here comes the reliability testing. It requires the test cases to be executed in a loop. We can have two types of loop. One is the iteration loop, and second one is the timed loop. In iteration loop, we can have repeat statement, repeat comma 50, and in the test program 1 to be executed 50 times with the corresponding test case 3. And in the second example, we can have the timely loop, that is, we are telling the test tool or the framework to execute for 5 hours the corresponding test programs with the corresponding test cases. So it will execute all the test programs 1, 2 and 3, then test program 2 with all the test cases, test program 3 with all the test cases, test program 1 with the test case 2 and test case 1 and test case 5 for 5 hours. Next requirement is grouping of test scenarios. This grouping of scenarios allows several test cases to be executed in a combination manner. That is, it can be executed in the order wise, or it can be executed in random order, or it can be executed in a loop all at the same time. So here comes the example, group scenario 1. Here we can have the statement parallel comma 2 is 2 instances can be created of whatever the action has been followed, and is the we are going to connect between the two operations, that is repeat and the parallel. Repeat comma 10 is the we are going to execute 10 times, that is in the loop at scenario 1, that is the scene 1 is the scenario name. Then scenario 1 is being given with the corresponding statement test program 1, test program 2, test program 3, test program 1 with the specific test cases 2, 1, 5. So here two instances of all the test cases or given scenario will be created. Then we need to execute the corresponding scenario for 10 times. Next requirement is test case execution based on the previous results. Here comes the regression testing methodology. So it will be need to rerun all the test cases which were executed previously, or rerun whichever failed test case or not run test case which has been done previously, or resume the testing wherever we stopped in the previous time, or we can execute all the test cases which were executed on the corresponding month and the date. Our next requirement is remote execution of test cases. So here also it has been possible to have the central machine whichever controls the set of machines by the corresponding execution of multiple test cases. So we can have the test results and the logs can be consolidated into the central machine, and this progress report of testing also can be found from the test console. Test console is nothing but the central machine. We can have the pictorial representation of this. That is, the central machine is the test control, whichever is being shown in towards the left side, and this one it will have the multiple tests to be executed by multiple machines. That is the test case execution, and here we can have the result consolidation and have the progress report. And next requirement is automatic archival of test data. That is, archives means we can have the previous test cases to be executed and we have stored there over there. And what it will include means it can include what are the configuration variables and what the scenario have been used and what the test suits or the programs were executed and from which path it has been executed. Next requirement is reporting scheme. Once all the test cases have been available and results are ready, we need to choose the reporting scheme. What it include? It should include all the framework or the scenario and the test suite and corresponding test programs and the test cases, when it starts and when it has been completed, and result of each test case should be analyzed, and log messages whichever has been captured during the execution, and the category of the events and log of events which has been occurred, and we need to maintain the audit messages which is used to tell the behavior of the test cases during the execution. And next one is independent of languages. That is, whenever we are doing a coding for automation, we should consider these scripts to be executed, scripts to be written in an easier manner to be understood by everyone. That is, we need to use a familiar programming languages like C or C++. So it should be independent of programming languages, and framework also should provide a choice of programming languages and their scripts. And also some of these scripts, it will force the test or the test tool or the framework to support the corresponding language, but it should not happen like that. And also framework or the test tool should work with different test programs which has been written using different languages and also the scripts. And last requirement is portability to different platforms. That is, we need to consider the corresponding interfaces which are supported in the various platforms. That is, it should support both the architecture, 64-bit architecture and also the 32-bit architecture. Here, portability to different platforms is a very basic requirement. And here, the language or the scripts, whichever is being written for the test suite in the corresponding framework, should not contain any specific calls that is specific to the platform. It should work to all the corresponding platforms. Next topic, so that's all about the general requirements for the test tool. Next topic is selecting a test tool. That is, selecting a test tool is an important aspect of test automation. It can have some of the reasons. That is, free tools are not well supported and get phased out soon. That is, it is very dangerous to have the free tools which is available in the market which consist of problems with the test tool. And next one is developing in-house tools takes time. That is, in-house tools is being generated or the developed by the personal interest of some of the few engineers. So what they will do, so once they leave the organization, then that in-house tools are not at all usable one. Next one is test tools sold by the vendors are expensive. Definitely, whenever we are getting the test tools which is available in the market, which is compliant to standards, should be expensive. And test tools require strong training, because in order to have the successful test automation, the person whoever is using the tool should have a flexible training. This training consists of specific to the scripting languages used in the tool, and they customize how we can customize the tool, or how we can add the extensions or plugins to the corresponding test tool. And test tools do not meet all the requirements for the automation. Yes, it is a generic one. It cannot satisfy all the requirements for a particular customer, and not all the test tools run on all the platforms. That is, we cannot tell these tools we can run in all the platforms, right? So these are the, some of the reasons for selecting the test tool. Next one is criteria for selecting the test tool. That is, we can have four criteria are there: meeting requirements, technology expectations, and training or skills and management aspects. So first heading is meeting requirements. So we can have many tools are available in the market. All are do not meet the all the requirements of a given product or in a given organization. So every tool or the different tools, whenever we need to evaluate, it depends on some of the various factors like effort, money, or the and the time, right? So this is the first case we need to consider. And the second one is, it does not provide backward compatibility or forward compatibility. That is, we cannot choose the tools based on the forward or the backward compatibility. For example, when we consider the product which has been supported with the SDK version 2, and whenever we are using the test tool for automation, that is the version 1.2 of SDK, what happens here? Whenever we need to run the product, for the some of the components, it will not run because some of the components it will not be supported in the version 1.2. So the third case we need to consider may not go through the same amount of evaluation for all the new requirements. And in the fourth one is number of test tools, it cannot differentiate between the product failure and the test failure. That is, it increases the analysis time and also the manual testing. It requires the manual testing, and also it will not help in the analysis. It takes some of the troubleshooting and debug and error messages. In the case of manual testing, it will not automate things. Next criteria is technology expectations. Here in the first case, test tools may not allow the test developers to extend or modify the functionality of the framework. In order to modify the functionality, only there are very few tools available in the market. It will support the extensibility for some problems. This extensibility and the customization are the important factor to be considered. Next one is, we can have number of test tools whichever is likely to link their libraries to with our product binary file. So when the libraries has been linked with our product, that is called as the instrumented code. So what happens here, some of the portions of retesting, it requires retesting, because after that libraries has been removed, that portion it has been different, so it requires different types of testing. Next one is, test tools are not 100% cross-platform. That is, it will support only on some of the operating system platforms, and the script generated from these tools, it will not be compatible on the other platforms. Next criteria is training skills. That is, test tools require plenty of training. That is, very few vendors, they will provide training up to the required level. An organization level are being required here in order to deploy the tools. And also users, whenever we consider the users of the test tool, is not only the testing team, also the development team. And also we can have the test tools expect the users to learn some of the new language or the scripts, not the standard one. And this increases the skill requirements for the automation for the testing team, and also increases the demand for the learners inside the organization. Next criteria is the management aspects. Whenever we are going to select the test tool, it is very important for the management perspective to select the system requirements and also the cost involved whenever we are doing the upgradation of the software or the hardware, because this includes the cost as well. And whenever we are going to migrate from one test tool to the another, it will be difficult and also requires a lot of effort. So in this case, it is not difficult only in the test tool, whichever is being used in one test tool, it cannot be used for the next test tool because of the cost involved. And also from the management perspective, when we consider the return on investment, that is ROI, this changing in test tools are not at all permitted. So that's all about the criteria for selecting the test tool. Next, we need to consider the steps for tool selection and the deployment. So by learning all the previous section, we can have 7 steps. First step is we need to identify the test suite requirement among the requirements discussed over there. And if any requirement is there, we need to add it. And next one is we need to make sure all the experiences gained from the previous sections. And we need to collect the experience from other organizations, whoever is using the similar test tool. And the fourth step is we need to update this checklist of questions to be asked to the vendors in case of any of the cost or the effort or the support. And then fifth step is we need to identify the list of tools whichever satisfies the above requirements. And we need to keep priority one, which has been available with the source code. And sixth step is we need to evaluate and choose the one or the set of tools and train accordingly all the test developers or the test engineers on the corresponding tool. And the last step is we need to deploy the tool across the teams after training all the users of the tool. So that's all about the selection for a test tool. In the next coming videos, I'll be discussing the further topics. Thank you.